Who did everything they could to prevent the show from launching? Why did the marriage of Johnny Lee Miller and main Hollywood beauty end? And what did Lucy Liu do to get haters all over the internet? Hi, I'm Dylan, and you're watching OSSA. Storytime, folks. In 2012, producer Sue Virtue revealed that CBS tried to buy intellectual rights for British Sherlock, but after a definite no, they decided to create their own version and call it Elementary. A big Hollywood scandal arose, and many actors simply refused to be part of the project. And the first one to do so was Johnny Lee Miller as Sherlock Holmes. Johnny seriously had no desire to be a part of the new CBS project until he read the script and realized it was a completely new story that was in no way similar to the adventures of Holmes and Watson from the UK. Johnny was quite a big star already. Back in 1995, he played a computer geek in Hackers, the movie, alongside Angelina Jolie, who soon became his wife. 1996 was marked with an even more popular movie, Trainspotting, in which Johnny portrayed Simon Sick Boy Williamson. In 2017, the movie got its sequel, T2, Trainspotting. The first movie is truly legendary, so if you haven't seen either one, we think that should change. In 1999, after three difficult years, Johnny and Angelina divorced. He once asked if he had ever regretted divorcing one of the most popular women in Hollywood. And here's what he said, "There are no regrets and no bitterness. Marriage was something that didn't work out, and I had to make a decision sooner or later. I decided to make it sooner." 2012 marked the peak of Johnny's career. The first season of the detective saga Elementary was watched by almost 12 million American viewers every week. This May, almost at the same time that season 7 was launched on CBS, Broadway premiered a play with some musical numbers, Inc. The play received amazing reviews and even won Tony Award. We almost thought that theater would become Johnny's new hobby, but it turns out that the last show was on July 7th. Back in 2018, another movie with Miller, Nine Lives, was announced. It is based on the sci-fi novel by Ursula K. Le Guin. Johnny's partner should be a holder of Oscar and Grammy Awards, Common, who is known for The Hate U Give. This story unfolds on an outer space drilling station on a planet called Libra. Miller and Johnny play two drilling workers who are extremely lonely. Unfortunately, there hasn't been any news about the production yet, but we hope that after his long-running Sherlock trip is over, Miller will get to new projects, which we'll be sure to tell you about. Those who had intentions of wooing the charismatic American Sherlock are too late. In 2008, Johnny married actress Michelle Hicks, who also made an appearance in Elementary, portraying Thea Moser in the episode The Ballad of Lady Frances. After 11 years of being together, Johnny and Michelle are the example of how it's important not to marry the most successful woman, but the one who is right for you. Natalie Dormer as Irene Adler. Let's move on to Sherlock's interest, who worked on his nerves quite a few times. We're talking about Natalie Dormer, who portrayed the charming criminal. One has to cover their eyes and ears in order to not spot her on the big screen. A UK valedictorian who failed her exam at the University of Cambridge and debuted in the movie Casanova with Heath Ledger and Jeremy Irons. The director liked Dormer so much that her character was given a bigger role. After that, there was Tudors, where she portrayed Anna Boleyn. Back in 2011, Madonna included Natalie in her movie W.E. The same year, the actress got a role in the successful blockbuster Captain America: The First Avenger, and in The Hunger Games saga, in which Dormer portrayed Cressida, a rebel from District 13. However, Natalie's got her army of fans after the role of Marjorie Tyrell in the legendary Game of Thrones, and of course, after this accidental kiss with Jennifer Lawrence. Natalie portrayed a small but tremendously important role in the Elementary world. In the spring of 2019, a movie with Mel Gibson, Sean Penn, and Natalie Dormer called The Professor and the Madman aired. The movie is about a respectable scientist who makes a deal with a patient in a psychiatric hospital for dangerous offenders in order to create the first English dictionary ever. Recently, Showtime has announced the premiere of Penny Dreadful, City of Angels, in which Natalie Dormer is to play the lead character. It is supposed to premiere in the beginning of 2020. Natalie will also take part in a Netflix project, The Dark Crystal, Age of Resistance, which also has Taron Egerton, Andy Samberg, and Helena Bonham Carter in it. Aidan Quinn as Thomas Gregson. Brave Captain was portrayed by a true Irishman, Aidan Quinn. His first hit movie was in 1985, in which he starred alongside Madonna. It was called Desperately Seeking Susan. Actually, Aidan has always been lucky with his onstage partners. Think Robert De Niro, Jeremy Irons, Brad Pitt, and even Anthony Hopkins. Quinn received two Emmy Awards. The first one was in 1985, when many of you weren't even born yet, and it was for his role in the TV drama In Early Frost. The second one was received in 2007 for his role of Henry Lawrence Davies in the historical drama Bury My Heart at Wounded Knee. Just like Lucy Liu and Johnny Lee Miller, Aidan Quinn made appearances in all 153 episodes of Elementary, having portrayed the role of one of the best NYPD workers. Since 1987, Quinn has been faithful to the same woman, Elizabeth Bracco, an actress whose most famous role was Maria Spadafore, the wife of Vito Spadafore in The Sopranos. The couple has two kids, Mia and Ava. Ava has autism, and it's no wonder that Aidan spent a lot of time and efforts to help people with such an illness. Quinn is a famous philanthropist. He spoke at Night of Too Many Stars in 2003. It's a gala which fundraises for autism. Also, Quinn is an honorary board member of the National Alliance for Autism Research. Jon Michael Hill as Marcus Bell. Of course, we must mention Detective Marcus Bell, who practically appeared in all the episodes of Elementary. Despite the fact that the actor is still young, and of course, his best works are still ahead of him, back in 2009, he was nominated for a Joseph Jefferson Award for a supporting role in a play, The Tempest, at the Steppenwolf Theater Company in Chicago. Before Elementary, Jon had already acted as a policeman. Back in 2010, he portrayed Detective Damon Washington in the ABC police procedural drama Detroit 187. In 2008, he acted alongside such stars as Viola Davis, Michelle Rodriguez, and Colin Farrell in Widow. This neo-noir crime film was created by Gillian Flynn, who is definitely one of the best-selling authors of our time, the author of the hit Gone Girl. So if you were wondering what movie to watch tonight, go get popcorn and get started. Ophelia Lovibond as Kitty Winter. Her name, like the cult Shakespeare's character, defined her destiny. However, if she hadn't become an actress, she would have been a lion trainer. At least, that's what she says. When asked who would win in a fight, New York or London, she said, "New York has more weapons," but her first acting steps were made in the UK. She first appeared on TV at the age of 12, in the sitcom The Wilsons, in which she got in by lying about her age. Well, if everyone believed her, she must be one hell of an actress. Ophelia's first debut on the big screen was in 2005 in Roman Polanski's Oliver Twist. In Elementary, the girl plays the role of Kitty Winter, Sherlock's student and follower. And despite the fact that Ophelia was only in 15 episodes, the fans remember her charm and British accent well. Lovibond's best works are, perhaps, those in the Marvel Universe, namely Thor, The Dark World, and Guardians of the Galaxy, in which she played the Collector's assistant, Karina. She last worked on the movie Rocketman, which had the audience standing and applauding after the premiere in the con. We love Ophelia, and we're looking forward to see her play a lead character on the big screen, as she totally deserves it. Lucy Liu as Joan Watson. It's hard to believe, but one of the brightest stars of the show is 50 years old. Hollywood fell in love with this discreet but very charismatic woman back in 2000. Just think about it. She is one of the Charlie's Angels. Besides, she also played in the Oscar-winning Chicago. She also portrayed key roles in the first and second parts of Kill Bill, the neo-noir crime thriller Lucky Number 11, and RZA's movie The Man with the Iron Fists. On the 1st of May 2019, she got a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Despite all her achievements, taking part in Elementary in 2012 was definitely the right decision, as now she's become world famous. At the Emmys red carpet in 2019, Lucy revealed even though shooting ended in December, she only felt it later when she started having more free time, because she did not have to sit down and memorize lines for the show. Lucy didn't stay jobless for too long, and August 15th marked the CBS premiere of a dark comedy drama by Mark Cherry. Mark Cherry is the one who created the magnificent Desperate Housewives, in case any of you have forgotten. The movie is about the three women from different times, the housewife of the 60s, the socialite of the 80s, and the lawyer of 2018. The movie shows us how the role of women has changed over the years, but how women's reaction to cheating hasn't. It's called Why Women Kill, and it's already available on CBS Online. Also, after Elementary was over, Lucy got more time to develop her other hobbies. Her fans know that Lucy is a great artist and a sculptor. Here are some of her works. In the beginning of the year, Lucy had a big exhibition in Singapore, and here's what she told the press. "It's exciting to be able to connect with new audiences through all expressions of art. Some say that a talented man is talented in everything, and Lucy Liu just proves it well. The only thing Lucy is not so great at is love. She's had a few boyfriends, but it didn't go further than planned. When Lucy Liu welcomed her son in August 2015, the single mom proudly announced that he was brought into the world via gestational carrier. "I don't really think about it at all. I just went ahead and did it. I didn't realize there was criticism until after I sent out the information that I had my baby through a gestational carrier. And my friend said, 'Don't listen to what some people are saying.' I didn't realize people were saying anything negative." Lucy has always been a strong woman, and we're glad she inspires many women around the world. Only, we'll be even more glad if she can find the love of her life. That's all for today, and that's all for Elementary. Did you ever dream of Holmes and Watson becoming a couple at the end? Share your thoughts in the comments. Subscribe and ring the bell to stay informed about your favorite shows, folks.